हेलो
हेलो एवरीवन, आई वृंदा अग्रवाल वेलकम यू ऑल टू द एडिमाउंस यूट्यूब चैनल टू हैव एन इनलाइटनिंग वेबिनार विद उज्जवल आशुतोष, द फाउंडिंग चेयरमैन ऑफ क्षितिज एनजीओ. इट इज एन एनजीओ फॉर्मड बाय स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ दामोदरम सनिल विजय नेशनल लॉ यूनिवर्सिटी विशाखापट्टनम. विदाउट टेकिंग मच ऑफ अ टाइम आई वुड लाइक टू कॉल युक्ता बत्रा टू टेक ओवर नाउ, बट बिफोर एंटरिंग आई वुड से that this NGO was formed in order to bring about a change in the lives of unprivileged children, youth, old age and women, and to promote in empowerment, creativity, innovation, peace, harmony, and also towards sustainable development goals of United Nations. It is an Indian-based, not-for-profit and non-political organization. So, Yukta.
Hi, Mr. Ashutosh. How are you?
Hello, Yukta. I'm doing good. What about you?
I'm also doing great.
Okay.
So should we start? Yeah, same here. So should we start with the line of questions?
Yes, please proceed.
Okay. So the very first question is that, you know, most NLU graduates seek to get into top law firms of the country, but you on the other hand have decided to start with your own NGO. So how did it all happen? So please give us a brief introduction about your NGO.
When you enter into NLU, there is this rush for corporate as well as judiciary and litigation. On the contrary, if you look if you look into the career options after BLLB degree, social activism and social litigation is there. Only thing is, people haven't traveled this road much, and this is like people like taking. If you take my own example, so the situation with me right now is that for my juniors, either I will be an example or I will be an example. Don't you think this is a confusing statement? It will be like, if I succeed, then people will cite me as an example. That look up to him. That he did this thing in by choosing this career. If I fail, then again people will cite me that don't choose this career because you have the option. So in both the cases, I will be cited for sure. And talking about this thing that already this career opportunity is there, and I chose to explore this particular thing. And definitely, I would like to thank professors like Jen Saleh, who taught us law and poverty. And faculty like K. Sudha, Shri Sudha, Madhashu, Nirmala ma'am, these all people were motivation from the very beginning. And somewhere their motivation actually helped me in creating this and in the formation of this organization.
That's a very interesting way to see that if you will be a failure, then also you will be seen and people will cite you. And even if you progress, that's a very interesting opinion that we can formulate. The other question is that enlighten about your brainchild. Like, there are various initiatives that Kshitij has taken from education and environment, though they are very like different in their respective aspects.
So yeah, first of all, this Kshitij is a Hindi word, and we had this. I told you one of our motivation was K. Sudha ma'am, and her initial was K. So it was like we were pretty sure that we have to think a name from K, and this Kshitij came into our mind because it means horizon. And if you must be knowing that horizon means horizon is a place where the earth and sky seems to meet, but that's not the reality. Same is the state of development, the situation in the country about the education, especially the public education system, and the pollution are on raise, and we need to tackle this situation as soon as possible. So we decided to form this organization. And if you look into the most of the problem, like you sit down, discuss about the situations and problem around, you will find that somewhere we have, like our country is facing two important issues. First, either people are illiterate or the people who are literate are ignorant. That is ignorant literate. So this is the major situation in our country. So we you cannot blame the commercialization of education. The thing is, our public education system is not that good that we have, and somewhere the value education, we have came far away from value education, and we are seeing the result, and the situation will be worse if we do not tackle this situation. And in most of the situation, you will find that education is important. So we took up this particular situation, and especially the free education. And apart from that, I encountered with this migraine issue back in standard 9th, which started affecting my academics as well. So the pollution was an issue in my mind from the very beginning. So we got a chance to work on waste management. And during pandemic also, we started the campaign called Feed the Penguin for proper disposal of biomedical waste. Everywhere you will find the advertisement that wear mask, maintain social distancing. But right now, no one is talking about its proper disposal. And if you say that the disease is communicable, is spreadable, you need to talk about that situation, tackling that situation as well. So these are the two important objectives of the organization. Apart from, we also work on this women's health and hygiene, that we go to different villages every month, make them aware about menstrual health and hygiene, and distribute sanitary pads there.
So what exactly are you doing on ground level to provide education? If you could like elaborate more on it.
So I feel that this interview is placed a few days before of the actual thing. Right now, we are conducting free classes in the village named Iruvara, where so far 24 students have enrolled with us. And we are giving them, we are not only providing them education, but also taking care of their other needs as well, like a stationery, or if they want to fill some form or something, we are taking care of that. But in another 20 days, we are planning to come up with a free school itself. So we will be launching a free school concept. The tuition that we are running right now is named as Alluri Sitaram Raju Sahaj Siksha Yojana. So Alluri Sitaram Raju was freedom fighter of this place. And right now we are living in a society where no one even tends to give you a pen. And these people sacrifice their life in a dream of a better India. And somewhere we are not standing on their dream. So we named it after his name, so that we can contribute our bit in his dream. And one of actors committed it's controversial that whether it was a mother or a right, but he was our favorite, that Sushant Singh Rajput. And his dream was free education. So combining both the vision, we are coming up with a free school concept in another 20 days.
That sounds really great. All the best for your new initiative.
Thank you.
So you were, when I was going through Kshitij's website, and you were recently interviewed by SCC Online, which is kind of a milestone for the organization. So how does it make you feel? And the other important question is that arose in our head was while reading your interview. You have declared the organization as non-political, which is not a standard protocol being adopted by other organizations or NGOs. So would you like to elaborate?
So yes. If I'm getting correctly, there are two questions about this SSC interview and this. Okay. So no doubt the SSC's interview and that they published it on their website and everywhere did boost our morale. And we felt encouraged. This that actually matters. That motivates you to work further. Moreover, answering your next question, that we have mentioned it as non-political. That's non-political and non-religious. And that's why, if you will see, that most of our activities are carried out in Andhra Pradesh. Basically, I am from Bihar. And if you look into the activities, most of the people tends to go towards social activities for political intention or benefits. So for me, in Vishakhapatnam, people don't know my caste, religion or anything. And to an extent, I feel that constitution is working for me, which won't be in my own hometown. And people might relate it to politics, that in future I want to go into politics or something. So that's why we have made it our stand very clear that we are doing it in a place where we just want to give the service, because we can see the problem, and also we want to come up with a solution. You know, talking about problem is easy, but you need to come up with the solution. And once you do that, then in my opinion, then talking about problem helps. So we don't want to involve ourselves into politics, and that's why we have mentioned this.
That's great. So what are your aspirations and inspirations, Ujwal, at a personal level?
So from after formation of this organization, we want to make the quality education accessible for all, and along with the sustainable environment around. And as a parent or as a society, we tend to preserve gold, land, properties, and for our future generation. But in my opinion, I personally think that building a safe and clean environment is the best that we can offer to our younger generation. So that's the mind's aspiration. Definitely.
Yeah, because I have heard so many stories about exploitation. Like one of our prime ministers used to get water delivered to his house from Kashmir every now and then. So yeah, there has been a lot of exploitation of resources, no doubt about that.
The gap between the rich and the poor is widening, and it's widening very fast. And we as a youth need to take up this issue as soon as possible.
So running an NGO which is diversified in task is itself quite complex. So what are the ground level difficulties that you face? Definitely, there's an aspect of that you have to cater to both your NLU studies and the other one that you have started to be NGO. But the other side to it is the ground difficulties that you come across. So what are that? Please give us an insight about it.
So if you can look into the organizational setup, it's we are from a Hindi speaking state, and we are established in a rural area of Vishakhapatnam, which means most of the population knows Telugu, and we aren't aware about the same. Like, we can understand, but we cannot still communicate. So one of the major issue with us was the language barrier. Other was managing our academics, because in NLUs you have a hectic schedule. Professors and in fact you yourself expect a better quality progress. You need to do more debates and this thing. So these were the hurdles. Apart from that, there were existing NGOs which had the vision, and I had the vision that we can collaborate and work in better. But again, the superiority thing, that thing was faced. So these were the three major issues that we felt: that managing our academics and running an organization, then the language barrier and the existing NGOs. Apart from that, despite of everything, we had one simple thing in mind, that there will be hurdles, there will be problems, but we had to go on. Like the water, we don't have to stop our flow. We have to go on. And that's why we kept changing our platform and objectives whenever and wherever needed.
That's a very interesting example of water, how it flows through all the hurdles. And I hope that our viewers are inspired by it. So what is the due process of registering an NGO? Like, basically, there are three ways. Either you can form a trust or you can form a company. So what is the right way and which is preferred over the other?
When we were... we were going for the registration of the NGO. We were confused too, like whether we should go for Section 8 company, that is non-profitable company, or the trust, or under Society Registration Act. These are the three ways you can get an NGO registered. In society, we found that it runs in a most democratic way, that we came up with a vision to change the education system, the environmental existing environmental issues, and the menstrual health and hygiene. So this is a vision, Kshitij should not be something where Ujjwal Asutosh or someone like treasurer, secretary, people from my team, after them, the people with the same vision can come up. And for this, the Society's Registration Act paves you the way where you can elect members every year. So that's why we went for Society Registration Act. You can also go for trust, where you can have your family members in it. In societies, you cannot have your family members, which means there is no option for nepotism in societies. Section 8 companies, you have board of directors. So we felt that Society Registration Act is best if you don't want to keep the NGO with us and our family only.
definitely is less feudal if there's no nepotism in it. So this leads me to the another question that a new wave of youth is asking for change, and it can be felt around all around us, like be it India or around the world. So how can interested people volunteer with you?
So the process is as simple as that either they can write us on Instagram or a mail would be a bit formal, but as you can, you know, we appreciate the intent and interest of the people. So even if they approach us on Instagram or through a normal text, we consider them because we look into the interest they have, and we want to pave the way where they can join us as volunteer than a member. And if they prove themselves and they stand on the vision, they can be the next chairman or so. So it's that open.
Wow. So at last, we would like to know about your life lessons. Like, it's been a journey of almost 20 plus years. So what are your life lessons? That's a very interesting question I ask almost every guest on the channel, and we get to learn something.
So in 20 years, not 20, in fact, 24 years of my life, what I have felt is, okay, I told this thing, okay. So yeah, in 24 years of my life, what I have felt is that there will be issue, there will be problems. And if you stand against the flow, like again, taking example of water, if you stand against the flow, you will face challenge. If you go with the flow, there will be no problem with you. Your life will be smooth and calm. But if you want to make a stand for the reason or for the cause you believe in, there will be problems. And if you genuinely believe in that and you want to change that, stand strong. Never give up. Never ever give up. There will be hurdles. There will be people. In fact, for me, there was a guy from a place that he used to bully and this thing. So there will be problem. They will criticize you. They will bully you. And but you have to believe in yourself and your vision. And most important, you should always know and remember that if you are doing something, why at all did you start? And look into the journey that you have traveled from the beginning till date. And this will, you know, help you in motivating that, yes, we have traveled this far, we will definitely go. At least this helps me. So I would say that never give up. Never, ever give up.
That's quite inspiring. I believe that believing in oneself is one of the most difficult paths to do in your early 20s. And once you have done that, then it gets easier and you can take new molds towards life. Right. So thank you, Ashutosh, for giving us time and the opportunity to ask you questions.
Thank you, Yukta. Actually, I thank you for giving me this opportunity. Thank you so much. Thank you. And all the best to you and your team.
You're most welcome.
So I would like to thank everyone for joining our live channel. And I would now take a leave from you. And until next time, thank you.